I know that there is another park that has like a piece of your heart that you've really enjoyed. So I wanted to talk to you about that one as well. And that's Sequoia National Park. So what would you say is kind of some of your favorite aspects of that that national park?
So there's a lot of things about that park. That park is just very surreal and magical. And I'm very much a tree person and a plant person. I always say in another life I would be a botanist. Yeah. And the trees there, especially coming from the East Coast, the trees there are enormous. Like, it's just, you can't even put into words what those trees are like. And the first time I went in the winter. So the snow with like the red, red wood of the sequoia, the deep cinnamon color is just like, just spectacular. And then the Sierra Mountains right by there are just, you have the view of the trees and you have the view of the mountains. And it's just like a really, really magical place to go.
So for somebody that hasn't seen Sequoia National Park and these redwoods, how big are they? Like, everyone knows they're big, but how big are they really?
They're huge. So like, I put my arms around the tree and like I covered a quarter, if I was lucky, of the tree. They're just like massive. And the sequoias are a little bit different than the redwoods. They're really tall, but they're a lot thicker, which is really, which is really, really cool. And they're a lot lighter of a red color. They're not like that deep mahogany. They're more of like the cinnamon kind of color. And they're just like, it's, you can't put into words. I have a picture of me next to like three of them and I look like an ant. It's crazy. Especially me, because I'm so short. So I think I like really show how big they are.
Okay, so I feel like I thought redwood trees were what was in Sequoia National Park. I know there's Redwood National Park and Sequoia National Park, but I didn't realize they were two separate trees.
Yeah,
I'm learning something today.
They're the same family. They're redwood trees, but they're different species of redwood. So the sequoia is different than the redwood up north, the coastal redwood. And then the only other place on the planet that has redwoods is actually, I believe it's either China or Mongolia. It's like that area in Asia. But other than that, there are no like family of redwood trees.
So cool. Okay. So when you go to Sequoia National Park, what are some of your favorite activities to do there?
Yeah. So Sequoia, even just like driving the park, you can drive all the way up into the mountains depending on the time of year. In the winter, you have to have chains. You can rent them at the visitor center though right away, which is nice. So just driving it is spectacular. But there's a couple of my favorite spots. And Sequoia is kind of, Sequoia and Kings Canyon are pretty, they're not the same park, but they're connected. So even their maps say Sequoia and Kings Canyon, because like part of Sequoia is just like a circle in the middle of Kings Canyon Park, and then they kind of intertwine. So they're very, very similar. So usually when I talk about them, I talk about them together. But Big Trees Trail is a trail in Sequoia that I believe it's mostly paved. It's a really easy trail. It's like a quarter of a mile, all flat. And you just walk among the sequoia trees. And it's just breathtaking to see them. And you just, I feel like when I'm in them, I can't even speak. It's just so, like, it's like almost spiritual in there. There's just something about that forest that's just magical. So that's a really great trail. It's a pretty popular trail, but I feel like it's pretty easy to kind of get your space because it is such a big park. So that's like one of my go-tos there. There's also, you have to go to the General Sherman tree. It's the biggest tree in the world. It's kind of funny though, because you look at it and you're like, well, that doesn't look much bigger than the other ones, but it's it's by volume, so it's really, really dense. So that's a really cool thing, you know, to go and see the biggest tree in the world is pretty cool. So that's one of my favorites as well, and that's just like an easy paved path. You can walk right to it, and it's a really popular spot in the park. For seclusion, my favorite hike is the Redwood Mountain Grove. It's a very, it's not very well known, and I heard about it from a ranger. And it's a hike. It's a pretty fairly easy hike, if I remember correctly. I don't remember the mileage. I want to say around maybe 6, but there wasn't too much elevation. There was some, but it's, you know, like a definite trail. But you walk right among redwoods as well. And I think it's the largest old growth redwood. It's the largest old growth redwood forest in the world still. So it's like that specific area.